Surrogacy is an increasingly popular yet silent trend in Uganda, with an increased number of women renting their wombs to financially able couples that take this option of reproduction. While this could be good news to couples who are not able to conceive normally, there is a concern of lack of an enabling law regulating the service, which raises legal and ethical questions not well answered by present-day Ugandan laws.
We have had concerns in some of the hospitals where their children are stolen and all those, but that is not, for me, in my opinion, that is not the problem. The problem is some of the communication is missing in families, and that's why we have those concerns. But with the law coming, it will help to regulate. But even now, when it is not there, we know that some of these clinics are helping the parents have babies.
Dr. Damali Najitam Soke, the principal of Makerere School of Law, believes that there is need for an enabling policy on surrogacy. She explains that this could be of great relief to women with reproduction challenges, including the disabled.
I think it is a matter of choice. If one decides, well, I will not produce a child the usual way, but I'll get a child through surrogacy, that is a right. What matters is that this person with a disability has that wide range of choices and the leeway to be able to decide what they want to do. Not for someone to say, oh no, for you, you are difficult to assist to give birth, you can't climb our bed, so you just go and get someone to produce a child for you, or to carry the child for you. Let the person with a disability decide what they want to do, what is good for them, and then support them.
Fortunately, the judiciary revealed that a law is yet to be established to regulate surrogacy, as well as help them deal with issues that may arise out of surrogacy-related cases.
What I can confirm is that government is coming up with a law to regulate issues of fertility, to regulate issues of surrogacy, to regulate all these issues.
In Europe, there have been incidences where surrogate mothers become emotionally attached to the babies and tried to refuse to hand them over. While in India, wealthy infertile couples from Europe have taken advantage of poor local women and used them as surrogate mothers for much smaller fees than they would have been paid in Europe. Presence of a law should clearly spell out who can be a surrogate mother, the procedure of becoming one, as well as the relationship between the surrogate mother, the baby, and the genetic parent, among other important aspects. Rachel Nachuala for Urban TV.